In by finding a position that's comfortable for you. Maybe it's sitting in a chair, on a cushion. Maybe it's lying down. Really allow yourself to get comfortable. Notice if there's any tension in your body, and whatever extent you can, allow your muscles to relax. And if you'd like, you can bring a gentle, easy smile to your face. Allowing these three qualities to enter your body. Really enjoying them. Being comfortable and relaxed. The simple smile on your face. You can begin to involve your mind by directing some kind words to yourself. Whatever would be sweet or loving for you to hear. Perhaps something like this. I'm so proud of you. Care about you so much. I love you with all my heart. You can say whatever you want. You know yourself best. Feel free to say whatever would be loving for you to hear from yourself. Very good. Now, bring to mind your easy to love person or animal, whoever that is for you. Begin to cultivate metta for them in a way that feels good for you. Perhaps using phrases as we did just now, mental talk. Perhaps using mental image, visualizing them being happy, laughing, playing, flourishing in their life. Perhaps by directly accessing feelings of love in your body. Just feeling the love in your heart. Any method of cultivating love is fair game. There's no wrong way to do it. And you may very well know which way you like to do it best. So feel free to do that. Simply cultivate love. Continue to cultivate love for your easy to love person or animal for another moment. Very good. Now, whatever degree you've cultivated love, if that's present in your experience, feel free to keep that around. We're going to begin to pray. Praying is also a cultivation practice. You can pray to whoever you want, perhaps to God or some avatar of the divine or a teacher, an ideal, your higher self, Mother Nature. Then you can pray however you like. Of course, if prayer doesn't feel like a fit for you, you can do a different technique that cultivates love or any meditation technique at all. But if you'd like, you can explore prayer, and in particular, praying for the world. Praying for the world. All of us live on this planet, planet Earth. And we share this planet with our friends and neighbors, fellow countrymen and women, the people of other nations. And we share this planet with our animal friends, our plant friends, our insect friends, the land itself and the oceans, the sky, this whole world. We all share it together. It makes our lives possible and we love it. We love this world, the people we share it with, and Earth itself. So, in whatever way feels good to you, pray for our world, the human world, the animal world, plant world, all of us sharing this precious earth. And for this practice period, however you choose to pray, you can explore the way of seeing that These actions have consequences. That your prayers matter. Perhaps in ways we understand, and perhaps in ways we don't. Just being open to the vast mystery that is this life and this universe. However we understand what we're doing here, it's stranger than that. More mysterious than that. More complex than that. So even if it's unfamiliar or unusual for us to pray, we can see what it's like to try out the view that in some way our prayers matter. With that perspective, praying for the world. Very good. Now, take a moment to consider if there are any acts of kindness that might like to manifest themselves in the world as a result of this practice of prayer that you've done. Anything that you might feel called to. Something that would be resonant with what you've prayed for. If anything like that comes to mind, if anything like that leaps up in your heart, set the intention to follow through with it, to take action based on it as you're able. And as you're ready, at your own pace, you can come out of the meditation.